You're forging your own path, so you understand that every step is a necessary step. Every downfall, every success, every good day, every bad day is necessary to help you get to that ultimate point of your self-actualization. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Robert Frost. If you had to ask me what I think the best life philosophy is, I would argue that it's simply to do it your way. There's no strict blueprint you have to adhere to. There are no rigid guidelines. I think we can create our own idea of what this life should be. I do believe that we were all put here to do magic, to be magic. And the only way to be magic is to live in a way that's authentically you. What's funny about this is, you know, my channel and in my content, I always speak about things that benefit my life, right? I tell you guys about my morning routine. I tell you guys about things I study, different philosophies and things that I apply to my life, different activities that I like to avoid or indulge in, right? To bring myself to a more centered place. But that's what works for me, and it's not for everybody. I can speak about my morning routine, right? I wake up at 3:30, I pray, I meditate, I thank God for everything in my life. I tell myself today's the day all your dreams come true. I work on music, I'm in the gym from 5 to 6. I make breakfast, I eat, I shower, I'm back on the music until I go to work. I'm a maniac. Everybody can't wake up at 3:30, man. I wake up at 3:30 for specific reasons that apply to my life and make me a more productive and more confident and more fulfilled person. That's not necessarily what's gonna work for you. All that to say, when I speak about things that work for my life and I might give suggestions or recommendations, none of this is spoken from a place of judgment. It's only spoken from a place of insight into my own mind and also wanting to see guys trying new things, wanting to see people trying new things to find that happiness and that peace, because most people are not living a life that fulfills them. Most people are not living a life that's full of tranquility and, you know, things that make them feel whole. And I would love to help change that in some way, shape, or form. And I'm still figuring it out for myself as well. The world is begging for you to forge your own path. So I'm gonna give 5 benefits for why blazing your own trail is the best way to live this life. Let's talk about it. First, it shifts the scope of what's possible and what's not possible in your family, your environment, your community. Most of our parents just want us to be okay, right? They want us to live lives and not have to deal with the stresses they did or the trials and tribulations, the hardships. And so the way this manifests in many occasions, in many ways, is they try to steer us into a certain direction so as to avoid this downfall, this tumultuous times that they dealt with, right? But you have to understand that their way of thinking was simply a product of circumstance. For anybody who's been in a situation where your parents cannot see the vision, right? Or your parents, they try to make you be more safe and more traditional. You have to understand that their magic, their ability to see and believe in magic was stripped away from them over time, whether it was from teachings, whether it was from their own parents, from just the hardness of the world and how tough life became. Somewhere along the way, they stopped dreaming and stopped believing in magic. Doesn't mean you should stop believing in magic. I think it's better if you believe in it and find ways to reawaken the people around you by showing them what's possible. So many people start from poverty, start from nothing, and become great. They had to believe it could happen before it could ever become a reality, right? Then you have people who, you know, they grow up in great households. Maybe their parent, one parent is a doctor, one's a lawyer. They go to these top schools, and so many of these kids face immeasurable pressure because to them, to their parents, they have to follow a strict code, right? They have to become the next doctor, engineer, or lawyer. Otherwise, why are you going to college, or why are we investing in your dreams? Or, you know, we can't push up, poke our chest out if you want to be a poet. But maybe that kid is a poet. You know, maybe that kid is a musician. Maybe that kid is a video editor. Maybe he's a writer. Who knows? It takes real courage for you to take that path and to not just adhere to what your parents say. Whatever feels real to you is what you need to be doing. That's the best way to show them what's possible. Because once you achieve that goal, I'm telling you, everybody starts to dream now. Everybody starts to dream. Imagine if you became that big time rapper, you became that world renowned chef that you dream about, and you didn't go to med school like your parents want you to. When you become that world renowned chef, they're gonna fall in love with your dream. They're gonna honor you for being able to take that step that they would never have been able to take. Because they didn't have it within them, but somebody stripped it away. Don't let the world strip it away. Forging your own path also gives you the ability to fail a lot and keep going. So when you're creating this world, when you're chasing something or pursuing something that's great that nobody around you has ever materialized, probably has never even dreamt about. Yes, they love you. Yes, they support you. Yes, they may see you make a mistake and wish you were doing something more stable. However, only you can truly see the world that's being created. So nobody else can qualify or invalidate your failure or validate your failure other than you. Which means you can try a million things. If nobody in my family has ever become a race car driver, then my journey to becoming a race car driver and all the mistakes I make, they don't really see that. All they see is that I'm trying to become a race car driver. That allows me the space to just try a bunch of things until something works. Try a million things in that space until something works. Only you really know what's going on. So fail. Feel free to fail. It gives you that freedom. Please fail a lot. Fast, bold, fail. It makes you grow. Next, it allows you to inspire more people and to find your tribe. Think of the greatest people in the world that you know. How many of them played it safe? Think about it. It's the bold and the daring who make history. Fortune favors the bold, not the timid. The special people are the people who are willing to fail a million times in front of the whole world until what they see and what they dream of becomes reality. Even when nobody else sees it, they believe in it. But they're willing to take that step and jump off the branch and just pray they learn how to fly on the way down. People who box themselves in and try to become cogs or live by conventional standards don't really inspire much. You might be able to respect their journey. Oh, he became a great accountant. And if that's your dream, beautiful, please pursue that. But you know what I'm saying? A lot of people who take these positions don't really want to be what they become. I can respect the guy that doesn't want to be, you know, an accountant. He wants to be a musician, but an accountant is his safety and he's not able to take that step to become a musician because he's scared or whatever the case may be. He's blocked somewhere. I can respect because he's still taking care of his family. I respect that part. However, he inspires nothing. His legacy is nothing compared to what it could have been had he went there and taken that risk. So you'll find along this journey, it's going to be people who believe like you do, who see the invisible that you see, who see the world-changing potential that you have and they also have. It's going to be those people who help you sustain yourself and create a lucrative empire or career just based off of being you. If you take that risk, I promise you, it may take a long time, but you have to be willing to beat at your craft and just to go and go and go. And when it's hard, take another step. If you can't fly, run. If you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl. If you can't crawl, drag yourself across the floor, but just don't stop. You're going to build your tribe. You're going to build your legacy. And your name will live forever. You'll also learn how to be kinder to yourself. Because the journey you're on, when you really embrace it, even if nobody can see it, you're forging your own path so you understand that every step is a necessary step. Every downfall, every success, every good day, every bad day is necessary to help you get to that ultimate point of your self-actualization. That allows you to be more patient. It allows you to be more kind to yourself and to not beat yourself up for mistakes or beat yourself up for things not happening fast enough. Because when you truly know it's your path and nobody else's, you're running your own race. You trust in divine timing and you don't try to rush anything. Rest in being patient. Rest in being able to wait until things are supposed to happen while you're still working for it, you know? Believe in yourself. And when you can do that, you're not going to beat yourself up like you otherwise would. And just overall, you're going to live a full life, man. You know, my biggest fear is getting to 85 years old, 90 years old, however old I'm going to become, and being on my way out and regretting the fact that I did not live according to my truth. That terrifies me. When I think about the hard days I go through, man, I just spent 30 hours on this song and only 200 people listened to it or something like that, right? I just spent 100 hours on this video, this script, and nobody just to send it to people and they say, nah, this isn't good enough. That stuff hurts, man. But you know what hurts more? Is never trying that stuff. And it terrifies me for you guys too and for the people in the world who never take that risk to do what they really want to do. They just become a cog, man. They just become zombies. I'm so scared of that. Because you can't get the time back, man. you cannot get the time back. If you just embrace your truth and forge your own path, regardless of what anybody else says, your parents included, yes, they love you to pieces. They'll love the fact that you're doing something that nobody else ever did. Yeah, they might worry about you. Man, how you gonna pay your bills this month? Yeah, they should worry because they're a family. They love us. They want us to be okay and sleep in a nice warm bed. But it's those dark nights that make us, man. It's those hungry nights, those cold nights that make us warriors. And sometimes it's only in those dark places that we find the grit to ascend, man, and become the greatest version of ourselves. And then once we finally do, now the world can see the vision. And not only have we lived a full life because we gave everything of ourselves to this life, we gave our most authentic selves to this world and our light to the world, but we've also inspired a multitude of nations, man. And our legacy and our work will outlive us. And it's not about the recognition, but it's about the fact that you can touch people 1,000 years from now because of what you did during your lifetime. What you've written, what you've spoken about, what you studied, what you produced. You following your own path can inspire a kid 100 years from now to follow his. You owe it to you. One of my favorite songs ever, I play it all the time, is Frank Sinatra, My Way. And Frank Sinatra was somebody who was not perfect, but he lived a full life, man. He lived a full life for as long as he could. And I think about the lyrics so often, man, because they apply so much to life. You know, regrets, I've had a few. But then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and I saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. But more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and I spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and I did it my way. Do it your way. That's all I got for y'all, man. Love.